The following work is part of my, that is Andrea's, current PhD project about the topography of Roman frumentaciones. A project with the aim of reconstructing the original aspect and function of one of the only ones certain porticus minutia known until now. I'm talking about the remains located at the area of Via delle Botteghe Oscure at Rome. River of inks had been poured on the question and in special way about the identification, either the name of the porticus minutia, the etus or frumentaria, and its compound in relation with the near and quite famous area of Largo Argentina, as aspect that we will deal with it now. But let's begin with some pills of history of archaeology to understand how many kinds of archives and collections we need to reconstruct what the area has given back from the past in the last 130 years of excavation. So these are those 130 years of excavations, at least some parts of them. So the Porticus Minutia area between the end of the 19th century and the 1930s was subjected to three big transformations. At its north side, the creation of Corso Vittorio Emanuele II and its big central sewage pipe through the demolition of the northern buildings of the old Via dei Cesarini. At the west side, the demolition of the block of San Nicola dei Cesarini to connect Corso Vittorio with Via Arenula, at least at the south side of the enlargement of Via delle Botteghe Oscure and the creation of its sewage pipe through the demolition of its northern buildings. In 1884, the demolitions of the buildings of the old Via dei Cesarini and the realization of its sewage pipe started. In that period, the city had to look a big construction site on plain air because of the several works in progress to transform the brand new capital of Kingdom of Italy in a modern metropolis like the other European capitals. The archaeologist Rodolfo Lanciani was the outstanding figure in the archaeological field, considering that he attended the majority excavations of that year, including our big sewage pipe of Corso Vittorio. In the area pertaining to our building, he found a complicated cluster of buildings which he sketched on his notes, nowadays kept by the Vatican Library under the name of Lanciani Manuscript number 13039 and published in the 21st plate of his Forma Urbis Roma. The 1909 town plan approved the lengthening of Via Arenula until Corso Vittorio Emanuele II across the block of San Nicola dei Cesarini, which was destined to be demolished and rebuilt in a new arrangement. The work started in 1926, and the administration office of the city entrusted the supervision of the excavations to Giuseppe Marchetti Long, an archaeologist pupil of Rodolfo Lanciani, that already studied the entire area. As is known, in 4 years, the diggers brought to light a great holy area of four temples A, B, C, and D, colonnades, two latrines, the probable curia of Pompeii, the magnificent large travertine paving, and a very tremendous number of inscriptions. After the discoveries, Giuseppe Marchetti Longhi and Corrado Ricci asked the help of the chief of the state, Benito Mussolini, to stop the demolitions and arrange the new archaeological area. So on October 15, 1928, Mussolini ordered to conserve the remains and to leave the rebuilding project, making a choice inserted within the celebratory programs of the Romanity that was a point of reference of the fascist ideology. The ancient buildings were rapidly restored and a new colonnade was built around the area, destroying several remains. Thanks to this work, the area was all ready for the inauguration on April the 21st, 1929, coinciding with the celebrations of the Rome's birthday. precisely during the arrangement of the area and the building of the modern porch, in its east side was discovered a 60-meter colonnade of 15 pillars under the street of San Nicola dei Cesarini. Practically, Rigon and restudied it, making his new discoveries dating its faces from the Republican period to the 5th century AD and reconstructing its elevation and pitched roof. But an important help comes to Andrea from the unpublished notes of Marchetti Longhi that have all allowed to identify all the modern changes. An example, thanks to the archive picture Andrea discovered, that the construction workers in 1932 held the height of the pillars to permit the realization of the modern porch. The excavation produced a lot of documents drew up by Giuseppe Marchetti Longhi during the works and published in part in six articles between 1932 and 1962 on the Bulletino della Commissione Archaeologica di Roma. Once he retired, he organized all his own unpublished papers in 21 folds, which delivered to the archive of the Comune di Roma, nowadays preserved by the Capitolini Superintendence at Centrale Montemartini. Particularly interesting are his Giornali di Scavo, a collection of all the journals of the excavations, handwritten on quotation marks, recycled paper. His correspondence with the National Insurance Office tells us about that. And an undefined number of photos taken during the excavation and often depicting remains that today doesn't exist and don't exist anymore. The pages are often legible with difficulty, with many messy or inaccurate indications, with missing pages and even wrong years. But in spite of everything, even now they are a treasure trove of information, as we can see. It has been very interesting to compare the archive documents with the nowadays state of the building. It helps, an example, to reconstruct the stratigraphic sequence found in the pits digged for the foundation of the modern porch and to understand the Republic phase of the buildings. The last document comes from one of the most important archives for those who study archaeology of Rome, the Gatti Archives, an enormous collection of Guglielmo Gatti's notes donated to the Central State Archives after his decease. Regarding via San Nicola dei Cesarini, within the archive, we find the notes of three construction sites. A dugout done in 1937 for a small sewage pipe, the dugouts dug in 1938 for the foundations of a new residential building called Condominio Argentina, and the big dugout done in 1941 for the sewage pipe of Via della Botteghe Oscura. Thanks to these notes, we can locate the position and the size of the compound wall of the Porticus Minutia at Via della Botteghe Oscura. But was this wall the rear wall of the porticus of pillars at Largo Argentina, like the last academic reconstruction suggests? I think Andrea thinks not, because georeferring the structures, we can see that the two porticus doesn't have the same orientation. So a confirmation of that hypothesis comes from the last archive of Rome, that is at the same time it's old as the marble plan of the city. Thanks to the work of the Forma Urbis project of the Stanford University, we can position the fragments of the area and see all the connections between the old drawings and the real situation, either on the archaeological so we can compare old drawings with the real situation, as Andrea said. Either on the archaeological map and the marble plan, we can see a space between the walls that could be occupied with surfaces like latrines and cisterns, in the same way as between the Porticus Minutia and the Crypta Balbi at Via della Bottega Oscura. The drafting of the archaeological map is still in progress, and the west and east sides of the building are still unknown, but I think that continuing digging out the archives of Rome, we will solve all the last enigmas. So, thank you very much.